about the behind story. Like, how did you decide on buying the Triestina club?
Well, you know, we did a lot of research, but we've had a lot of our football staff in place owing to their time at Venezia. And they were originally the ones that suggested that Triestina was the ideal club to be able to provide investment into and see value appreciation both at the club level and on the sporting side. And so we defer to the management team that we've built, and they saw the opportunity here and helped convince me that this was the right opportunity for me.
Absolutely. And what, it's been almost a year, right? How long has it been?
Well, we've only owned the club for 6 months. It certainly feels a little bit longer, but we've been pursuing it for about a year.
Uh-huh. And how has it been? What's the result?
I think it's a mixed bag like everything else, right? You take the good with the bad. I think we've generally seen better uplift from the society and from the fans and the supporters in the city than we originally thought going in. Obviously, the results on the field have been encouraging, and we hope to sustain them. But there are always, you know, unexpected challenges that you find in any investment, is the way I view it. And an investment in a foreign country for me is no different. So we are doing our best to deal with them and hope to have a long-term opportunity that arises from them.
Triestina is a huge deal for the city of Trieste. Do you feel responsible in a way?
Oh, of course. I mean, it's effectively a public good, right? No different than, you know, than the stadium, no different than any landmark that's in the city. It belongs to the people, and my job is to shepherd it from one place to another. Hopefully, we create some progress along the way, but we want to do it in a way that everybody feels involved in the success of the club. Everybody feels like they're helping contribute to it, because at the end of the day, sports are meant to entertain, and people are really passionate about it. They care so much, and we hope to be able to, you know, use that passion for the greater good.
So what are the goals for 2024?
Well, the goals have evolved a little bit, right? From the beginning, I don't think we're shying away from the fact that there is a possible promotion in sight, whether it's a direct promotion or through the playoffs. So we're focused on that. And that would obviously be a tremendous first year outcome. But I think so far we've seen many things that are very encouraging that we hope to build on as we go into next year, continue to develop our players, create a culture that can allow sustainability for us to repeat this into future years, and hopefully bring a few more fans along for the ride.
Absolutely. Something you've learned in owning a business in Italy for the past 6 months?
I don't think we have enough time for that. No, I mean, I've learned it can be challenging trying to manage any business from afar, especially from a continent away. So I try to be here as much as I possibly can. But at the end of the day, it's no different from any other business, is that you have a management team that you're trusting with implicitly. You understand what their capabilities are, and you try to support them and give them the resources to succeed and be their best selves. And I feel very confident that we have great people at the club, and I hope to support them in any way I can.
Fantastic. Is something you love about Trieste?
I mean, it's beautiful. The architecture is fantastic. The weather, the people. I just love being on the water. And I think you have the best of almost every part of Italy. You have cultural open-mindedness. And I love the location. You have great proximity to so many different cultures that enables a little bit of a melting pot that reminds me a little bit of the United States. You have people from various backgrounds that are working together to try to improve the city.